Hi, I'm Chaos here again. This is my second tech profile of my Saga of the Seven Barian Emperors series. As you can see, it's a Far Fist. Minifu Kirag never used this archetype, unfortunately. The Kirag some main deck cards aren't even released or shown yet, and probably they will never be released. So I have to think of something what could fit to that character. So I picked Far Fist because, of course, Far Fist is kind of similar to Hand Dust, if I guess, somehow. And that character also used some many Fire Attribute monsters, so yeah. It kind of seems like a 4-axis, regular 4-axis Fire Fist, but it has some few twists, I think. So let's go to the deck. Of course, your V part of Fire Fist pair. Of course, you pretty much send the Fire Formation spell card, and a spell of draft card you control, and then destroy a monster. So yeah, and when it inflicts damage, you can set the Fire Formation spell card directly from the deck, so yeah, really nice. We have pretty much a key card of the Fire Fist deck. Then two Gorilla. You must, when you get this card, destroy some master by battle, then you can get the Fire Formation spell card directly from the deck, and it does the same thing as Bear, except for spell and traps. So yeah, then three Dragon. If you activate this farmer's spell or trap, you can set the farmer's trap card directly from the deck, and you can send two farmer's spell or trap cards from the filter graveyard to spawn on a far fist monster from the graveyard. So yeah, pretty good. Two far fist snake. I don't see many using it, but I think it's pretty good actually. Its effect is once per turn, if a Fire Formation spell or trap is sent to a graveyard, except any damage step, you can set the Fire Formation trap card directly from the deck. So yeah, it's kind of similar to Dragon, I guess. And once per turn, if you control no monster, other monsters, you can send two face-up Fire Formation spell or trap cards, you control the graveyard, and draw one card. So I think it's kind of a control if you send two those continuous spell or trap cards to the graveyard, and draw a card, so pretty nice. Then two Battle of Fire Fist Boar, which was a recruiter of the deck, and it's also level 4 tuner. So yeah, it's a secondary effect which you don't really use much at all. And also with this one, you can summon fire synchro monsters. So yeah. Then three Cult Swords of Wolfark, which was the key guard of this deck, because this you want to exceed someone as much as possible, because you want to go for your Chaos number monsters, your especially Chaos number 106. So yeah, really good card. Unfortunately, of course, it's really expensive as well, so it's pretty much very difficult to actually complete this kind of deck in real life. Then one, Blaster Dragonlord of Infernos, of course. So every monster in this deck is fire, at least in the main deck. Then the Spellcast of two Rank Magic, Barian Spores and Limited Barian Spores, of course, because it's a deck based around Barian Emperor, so also using the regular Barian Spores and the more generic rank up. Also the seventh one, Rank Magic, was also revealed yesterday, the real life effect. Of course, it's very situational. Pretty much you have to draw it in the draw phase to activate it, and it has pretty much the same broken effect as anime, but if you draw it in the opening hand, you're pretty much screwed because it's completely dead card. But it's still really powerful, of course, so I have to test that card out. But I probably will include it in the rest of the decks. Rest of the decks in the Saga of the Barian Emperor series. Then of course the free Tenki, of course that's your part or destroyers. Level 4 lower, so yeah, really good card. Then, to Farmer Shintetsu, of course, you can use this gun, and also not a Beast Warrior in addition to your normal summoner set. Because all of which continuous spellcards have the effect that your Beast Warrior monsters gain one high attack, so yeah, that can become useful as well. Then, two farmers on Kyoko, you must activate this card, then start one set spell trap, and then you can't activate anything in that card in response, and it's pretty much sealed for as long as this card is on the field. Then, two Musical Phrasophone and the Dark Hole. Then, trap cards, two farmers on Tencent, pretty much Ross Recklessly in trap form, I guess. Can help you get to some monsters. And it has a continuous effect that you can all Beast of Warrior monsters gain with 300 attack. Another draft, Solar Morning, of course, Bottom Strap Hole, Transcend Reboot, Observer Question Device, Middle Force, 2 Dimension Prison, and 2 Fence Chain. So a pretty high trap lineup because it's kind of a more control oriented deck. It's not that aggressive. Then, the Synchros and Dex deck. Power 5 is Kirin. It's a pretty underrated card. It must Synchro Summon. You can set the one formation spell trap protect from the deck. And almost your opponent must lose one high attack for each spell of face of spell or trap card you control. So it's pretty good, I think. And some way before. So yeah, it's and Crimson Blade because it's a fire Synchro Master. Then was the main boss card in the deck, Chaos Knight 106, Chant 100. And while this card has a number monster attached to this Exchange Material, it gains this effect once per turn during either first turn. When a card or effect is activated on the field, detect one Exchange Material from this card and you do negate effects of all other face of cards currently on the field until the end of this turn. So it's a really good card, and you don't even have to have the regular Chant Hand as an Exchange Material. It's like a. But you have to be careful with this effect because it's a monetary effect. Which means you can't activate anything yourself if you want to use your effects. But it's a really powerful card, I think. Then, the Chaos Knight 101, Santos Dark Knight, of course. I use it as a secondary. Chaos Number in this deck. Then, of course, your number 106 Chant Hand. Of course, pretty much an effect failure on decks. This card is out in TCG, but it's pretty much you can only get it when you get the top 3 in the YCS, the Yu-Gi-Oh! Championships. So it's really hard to get card. Hopefully, it gets reprinted eventually. It's kind of lame that they picked this card because it's part of the over 100 numbers. Then, number 101 Santos Dark Knight, of course. Number 50 Blackship Corn. 2, part of 5 is Tire King. Best when card in TCG summoned. You can set 1 Farmer's and Spell Attack with from the deck. It was the same effect as Kirin, pretty much. Except when it's TCG summoned. Then, Orvisas Cornel, really good card. Detach 2 Exchange Materials, then start 2 Firefist Formation in your cards in the graveyard and or face up on your side, and 2 cards in your opponent's graveyard or face up on the side of the field, so the task to start to the deck. So yeah, really good. Then Punishing the Ghost of Sushi. It's here because it requires 2 level 4 Beast Warrior Masters, so it brings like a big Maestruck. Then Dharma Tarwolf, because of course your monsters are Beast Warrior. And then Evil Summon Exit on Knight, of course, nuke the field if you have less cards. Then Master Sun Forjin and Gal Cowboy. So this was my Girox Wild Fist deck profile. I hope you enjoyed it. Of course, the next tech profile in this saga of the Seven Banyan Emperor series will be Olit Battling Boxers. So I hope you enjoy this, and for now, goodbye, and Omega Chaos out.